What up, guys? The Cyborg here. And what the heck's going on? Learner drivers using the Gombak Lama route. And yes, that is exactly where we are. Jalan Gombak Lama on the Minion. Santai, right? Because you can see I'm just wearing my shorts. So memang santai je lah. It's been a while since I joined the Minions group. So just a santai ride. And where are we exactly going to? It's some kopi ladang where they are homegrown coffee and they make it and sell it. And I don't know where is it. So Shuk, the president. I think everybody here is a president. So yeah, anyway, Shuk will be leading the way. We have some Honda Monkey guys joining us as well. I'll let them pass me in just a bit. So as I said before, we are on our recovery phase of the pandemic, and large gatherings are still not advisable, and I'm also not a fan of joining mega gatherings and stuff like that. So we're just keeping it simple, keeping the group small, and yeah, basically it's more to just enjoying the ride. It's not about really trying to get the numbers, trying to have like 20 people joining or 10 people, stuff like that. It's just enjoying the twisties with the Minion, which I haven't done so in a while. We got President Fai as well, sporting top box now. So what's happening with the Brabster? Well, for my Brabster, actually nothing much has changed. We're still on the same setup. Still got my messed up sprockets. So my top speed is somewhat affected. But since we have the Honda Monkeys, let's check it out. This will be more of the retro classic style compared to the Z Pro, which is more of the more modern look of a Street Fighter. And can we? Yes, we can. As usual, being a Sunday, we got the cyclists, the awesome cyclists, using the road. So gotta be careful with those guys, because they all think, you see, they think they are like Tour de Langkawi fellas occupying the full lane. And you guys know how much I love bicyclists, cyclists. Totally love them. How about you guys? Have you guys gone for any group rides? How's it? How's keeping social distancing going on? So apart from cyclists, now you have people that are actually doing walking, trekking. See what I mean? Two abreast. I don't know whether you're overtaking that other cyclist or not, but the way you're going about it, I'm like, you might as well wait till you're going downhill instead of forcing yourself to overtake uphill. Ah, cyclists. So let me check. Yeah, Phi is even more santai, so I'm gonna just stick with this group. We also have a KTM Duke in the group. He's had to ride at the back, just doing the marshal sweeping, because he will be probably the fastest in the group. So if he were to be in front, I guess he would be stifled, and probably he would just leave us all in dust. Makan debu. How much are these Honda monkeys? I'm not sure. Probably need to Google it. Are they same price or more expensive than a Z-Pro or a Grom? I saw Olin's brand shocks there. I'm like, real? Really? Olin's? Cool. Yeah, seriously, now you have people walking on the street. Oh man, this road has really turned to shit, bro. And I don't mean the condition of the road. I mean, it's just too many of these recreational fellas on this road. If you're trying to enjoy the road, I think for this road, you probably need to come on a weekday and skip all this crowd. Well, at least we have our loud exhaust, so at least they can hear us coming. And why are you feeding the monkeys? Do not feed the monkeys. Do not feed the wildlife. Why don't you want to feed the wildlife? Then they get domesticated and they're going to start waiting at that corner, and maybe they will like start lunging at cyclists and stuff. Or these people that are walking, maybe start to get aggressive if they don't get food. So you're actually incorporating a bad culture or a bad behavior for the monkeys. That's why they say do not feed the wildlife. Some people do not understand that logic, I guess. So there you have it. Anyway, my tires I think are like 2 years old probably. My Pirelli Rosso scooter, I think. So it's probably not the best decision to push on this set of tires unless I change them. But my tires are the rubber, still a lot of rubber life to the tires, because this is not a bike that it's see a lot of heavy use, but doesn't mean that as long as you got the tread, means you can use it. Tires have their expiry dates as well, end of life. So yeah, it's a balance, you know guys, it's a balance. The balance between saving money, you know, keeping that money in your pocket, and the balance between the safety, you know, safety of your motorcycle, of your ride, so that you get the proper grip that you need coming from the tire. How do you decide which is which or what is what? That is always going to be your call. You know, no one can force you to change tires, just as no one can keep you from falling down because you are using old hardened tires that have no more grip. So you need to decide, you need to make the call. Bila nak tukar tayar, masih boleh pakai lagi tak? As you can see, I'm just rambling on and cars are coming, you got people walking. I mean, seriously guys, if you need to walk, just go to some jungle trekking. Why are you walking on the road? This is not a taman bunga, some kind of shit, and you're walking two abreast, no fucks given. These are the type of people I really feel like if I could punch them in the fucking face without any repercussions, as in like gonna report ka, gonna viral ka, I think I would, guys. I think I just would, you know. I would fucking kung fu kick the shit out of them for hogging the road. Because to me, you are not supposed to be on it anyway. Why are you walking on the road? Idiots, man. Idiots. Cakap nak healthy, cakap nak stay fit, tapi otak tak fit. Mental out. You can definitely tell it's been a long while since I'm doing my ranting slash ride slash rambling slash whatever else. And we have a other group that's behind us, so we're just gonna let that group pass, I think. It's easier to just let them pass than, you know, try to weave their way through your group. Hope you guys are enjoying the ride so far. And yeah, as well as my my rantings as well. Oh, lorry, baik punya. And bro, why are you in a blind corner? I think the line out sikit lah. Riding in the streets, riding in the track, totally different. Riding on the streets, you have blind corners. You don't have blind corners in a track. And of course, definitely you do not have two-way traffic on the track. So you need to know how to read the road. Being able to read the road, read the corner, and take the appropriate lines. You see, you got people on the other side of the road and cyclists and busy. Since when does this road become so fucking busy? I have no idea. Nak layan pun kena berjaga lah sekarang. Nanti bicyclist terlanggar ke, terlanggar jogger ke, susah pula. Oh, you want to stop also? For picture. His tire is a little bit kurang angin lah. Need to tell him about it. Thank you. And we are almost done with Jalan Gombak Lama. See what I mean? How many cyclists, all stuff like that. It's terrible, guys. It's not cool, it's not fun, it's terrible. Next up will be the Kopi Ladang, I think. And I have no clue exactly where this is. So, follow the group. Macam biasa. Passing through Genting Sempah, or meeting others, meeting another group. So the group becomes larger. I really need to work on this cover, this screen thingy. The vibes on this is like, damn, it's like on a mega vibrated. The vibes are crazy. So if you guys are wondering, hey, social distancing macam mana ni? Is this why the government was like reconsidering convoys? Well, to me, I feel like it's more on the walao, you just park there and take water like a fucking champion. No fucks given about the blocking the traffic, but whatever, man. As I was saying, to me, this is actually more like when you're riding, you're actually at a low risk because you're like on your own bike and you're like so far apart and you're wearing full face, you're wearing balaclavas, right? So I don't really see the effect of it. It's only when you're stopped, when you actually have a lepak point, where you get together in a large group to sit down and have drinks and whatnot, that's where the social distancing actually becomes messed up, I would say. Yeah. So as for riding, I mean, like, I don't see riding as a high risk activity. It's only when you're stopped, when you are like, you know, all want to park your bikes close together and, you know, you start to have, you start to talk to the other guys in your group. And if they are from unknown origins or, you know, stuff like that, then that's where it gets tricky. But otherwise, I mean, I can't see riding, the activity of riding as having problems. Be part of the cause of pandemic or the virus spread, I guess. If you keep your group small, which unfortunately right now, oh cool, I think that one is the bike that has the roof, the scooter. Like I was saying, if you are not in large groups like this, then you should be fine. Or even if you're in groups like this, if you guys are like pandai-pandai lah kan, apa kes, motor rosak. If you're in large groups, how many times have I said that word? Yeah. If you know how to separate, you know, like when you go to the spot to chill, you know how to separate yourselves out and stuff, then I think it should be good. But otherwise, you're going to have like 10-20 people in a single table and all so tightly bunched up together, then probably that is the reason why they are reconsidering allowing convoys. But I think it's more like you should limit the convoy, just like you limit how many people in a group or how many people can sit in a car. You should do the same. You should just limit the amount of people that should be in a single convoy. Then that would solve the problem. If you're like limited, like let's say 4 people per convoy, I think that's a pretty good compromise, I guess. Instead of outright banning, like, eh, totally, everything, ban, stop, cannot. And we are turning up to Kampung Janda Baik. Janda Baik. So he's riding and recording with his phone. Personally, I wouldn't recommend doing that, because if there's an emergency, are you gonna throw your phone in order to operate the clutch? Or I don't know, man. Hello, kerbau. That's a water buffalo, not a cow. Wow, check it out. Oh my my god. Oh man. Totally zero. I don't think so. No. After a brief discussion, we decided to abandon the idea of actually chilling back there. I am super amazed how people can just crowd such a shop and have no sense of, like, do you guys forget that there's this thing called COVID-19 still lurking around? That is just insane. So what we're going to do is apparently there's another cafe further in, but not sure whether they are open or not. And I think this is an ATV playground or something like that. Anywho, so yeah, gonna check out further inside and see what's the situation like. If it's just as crowded, then seriously, I don't know. Let's see what they decide. But I'm definitely not for joining large gatherings. It's just too crazy. So, pecah sini. You guys go this way. We kita pergi atau dia orang pergi? Kita straight. You guys need to top up minyak ke apa tak? Okay. Oh, got lah. Further down there got lah. Okay. Alright, bro. Nice to meet you. Ride safe, bro. Ride safe, bro. Right, bro. Ride safe lah. Kuantan. Okay, then we all also kita stop Petronas. Okay, ah, napam. Okay, okay, can. Okay, where's the other fella? Oh, waiting there already. Okay. Hmm, kat sana, tunggu kat sana. Ah. Okay, alright, bro. Right. So that group is actually came from Kuantan all the way here just to meet up with the other medians and basically us, our group here, and now they're heading back to Kuantan. So safe rides to those guys. It's gonna be quite a distance, I think about 2 hours, maybe 2 hours plus on a minion bike. So we are done, pretty much done with our ride. Just santai and grab some coffee and balik. So from here we were split up. From here later we just exit our own exit lah. Thanks for the ride, bro.
Okay, bro.
Right.
See you again.
Of course. Bye. Thanks for the ride.
Going home, right?
Yeah, going home lah. Ah, but we just terus jalan ni mah. We not stopping already, right? Right, bro. Thanks for the ride lah. Right, we are done and we're gonna finish off with a scary Karak Highway ride because I'm on a Brabster and we can't go fast on the highway. So it's not gonna be so fun. But we are done with the back road twisties. We want to chow. That should be it, guys. Unless there's anything interesting, as usual, I'll add it to the video. Otherwise, we'll wrap it up for today. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you guys enjoyed my rantings, ramblings, cursings, whatever. And yeah, I'll definitely be back for more. So, till the next one, guys. This is the Cyborg here. Ride safe and safe ride. And just for fuck's sake, I'm gonna just edit in. Here we are. The Warong Genting tunnel time. Nice. Nice. When you have a supercar and the highway is busy, that's all you can do. Even a Grom can keep up. I think there are bikers behind me that want to overtake. So, kasi chance lah lepas. Don't want to block the way.